Let us continue with the ER model to relational model. So in the previous video I explained about the mapping entity. Now let us see the mapping relationship. So what is the mapping relationship? Actually a relationship is nothing but it is an association among entities. Relationship is an association among entities. So what is the relationship among entities? Let us see. So let me write the diagram first. It's a pictorial representation of ER model. So this is enrolled is a relationship between the two entities. So the entities are the student and course. So here a student is an entity and the course is an entity. So the course is an entity. And here the relationship between the student and the course is the enrolled. So we are discussing about the mapping relationships. So in the previous video, I explained the mapping entity. Now coming to the mapping relationship. So for this, the attributes of enrolled is marks. The attributes are also called as the fields, joining date. And for student, the attributes are name of the student, roll number, and for the course, course ID, and then title of the course. Okay, so these are the fields that are for these entities. So here a student is enrolled for course. So a student may enroll for more than one course. He may do a C, C++ or Java. So a student can enroll more than one course. So for each course, they are having the course ID and the title of the course. So the course ID is suppose 01 and the title is C++. Course ID is 02 and the title is Java, like that. And for each and every student, he is having the name as well as the roll number. So the student should enroll based on the marks and the joining date. He is enrolled to the course based on the marks he get and the joining date of this student. So this is a relationship, a mapping relationship between the two entities. So let us see the mapping process here. So what are the steps you have to follow for the mapping relationship? Let's see the steps for mapping process. So first what we have to do, first as usual you have to create a table. Create table for a relationship. So you have to create a table for relationship. In the previous I had first created a table for an entity. Now you have to create a table for the relationship, that is for enrolled. After that you have to add the primary key. Add primary key of all participants. So don't be confused. So what is a primary key like that? So I'll explain clearly when I'm discussing about the keys. So actually the primary key is a unique key which can be given to only to that particular person. Means that key is different. A primary key, for suppose here the roll number is a primary key. This is a unique. So each student is having only one roll number that is different from the other person. So in that case you will give as a primary key. So add primary key of all participants entities as fields. So here whatever the fields that is you're having, so you have to give a primary key for the fields of the entities of a table with the respective data type. And next third point, if relationship has any attribute, means here you are having the attribute, the relationship is having the attributes. So if relationship has any attribute, then add each attribute as field as a table. Then add each attribute, this attribute as field of a table. Next, fourth point. After that, you have to declare a primary key. Declare primary key composing of all the primary keys of participating entities. And also you have to declare foreign key, because here one is depends upon the other. So this is a mapping relationship. So a relationship between the two entities. So one attribute is acting as a primary key. So if you are accessing that attribute in another entity, then it becomes a foreign key. So if it is having anything like that, you just declare foreign key constraint. So this is a mapping process for the mapping relationship. So these are the steps you have to follow while you are creating a mapping relationship. Thank you.